What's special about our course?
We worked synchronously and asynchronously, but using all the opportunities the Microsoft Teams offers.
Our course is a special course because it involves two lecturers from two countries. My colleague Anita from Riga, Latvia. It's about here. And myself, and we have students collaborating for about 10 weeks on Microsoft Teams. Hi, Anita. Would you like to introduce yourself?
Hello. I'm Anita Auzija, lecturer and researcher of the University of Latvia, the Faculty of Education, Psychology and Art. And in our faculty, we have a very lovely event every year, which is International Week of Professors, where I happen to meet Günther, my colleague from Germany. And I think it was a brilliant idea that we met and built an idea to start a lovely collaboration, and step in this international Microsoft Teams-based but course.
Usually you have a course, and in your classroom you have your students at your university. In this course, we had students from two universities together in one classroom. In Teams, and usually have one lecturer, and in this course we had two lecturers team teaching.
I was very happy to see how our students, both from Latvia and Germany, including students, Erasmus students from Turkey, used both opportunities, turning on their microphones and video cameras. Meanwhile, also our chat box was very busy. Immediate reactions, comments, questions appeared there as soon as students had something to say. And I think this is an added value when working remotely.
To support the students, we had various means. First of all, I think the structure of the course was very clear. We used learning modules which were on our learning platform, and the structure was always the same structure and very clear. Apart from that, we had some moderation emails that we sent to the students so that they knew what to do when. For the students to earn the credit points, they had to collaborate on a PowerPoint presentation in groups of six students, three from Germany, three from Latvia, and this was the product, the tangible product, and they presented their findings at the end of the course. But this was only the product. We had process two. Anita, what else?
The final product or presentation was important also, collaboration and active participation all through our video sessions. In addition, as a happy end, our students had a chance to meet also virtually, but in the 21st International Student Research Conference in Riga, where they met again together and could share the experience gained during the course.
The students really liked the format. I got a few quotes. For example, Maren said the cooperation among the students and with the lecturers was always positive. Or Yannick, I had a very pleasant time working together with everyone. And Didem, for example, lots of thanks to all of my group members who cooperated and supported so well, and to the rest of the course. I think as a resume of the course, I can say it was a very rewarding learning journey, both for staff and students, but it was also a very complex course and took a lot of time and energy to set it up. What else, Anita?
This gain is when students had the chance to collaborate and learn how to study in a different format, internationally, Above all, I think it was a lovely contribution to their digital literacy and learning about various platforms, not just in Microsoft Teams, but also learning how to meet informally in such platform as GatherTown, thus learning more about others and exploring possibilities of learning objects digitally, in addition to what we do when we research in different platforms regarding key knowledge or world knowledge students had to construct content-wise.
We already decided to have the course starting in February again, and hopefully coming to Riga, Anita?
Yes, also this May in 2022, the 21st Student Research Conference will be held. Thus, I believe that could be a lovely concluding seminar for all of us as well, those who participated in the next session of the course.